Hi, welcome to this question right here. So we're trying to solve this system by using the method that's called elimination. Now, elimination just kind of means you can actually add them or subtract them as long as you get rid of one of the variables, and that's all you have to do, okay? So what happened is, if I look at this question right here, first thing you check is the x line up with the x, y lines up with the y, the constant lines up with the y, I mean the constants. Then you double check to see which variable would you like to eliminate. Well, it seems like I have four y's on the top and four y's at the bottom already. They're the same. They must be the same for one of the variables. Then in this case, I am going to eliminate y first because it's already the same from the question, right? So, am I going to do add or am I going to do subtraction? It's 4y and the minus 4y down here. So think about it. If I just kind of add these two equations right here, the 4y plus the negative 4y becomes 0. So that way you just eliminate one of your variable. Okay? So I'm going to add two equations together. So pretend I'm adding the first equation and the second equation. So 3x plus x, it gives you 4x. This part is 0 already. This is equal to, I can put a plus 0 right there. 11 minus 7, we get ourselves the 4. So to solve for x, it's just going to turn to solve into 1. Alright? So, if x equals to 1, let's see, what will y be? Well, you have two choices. What you have to do is you just have to put the x equals to 1 right in the position of the x. And you can either pick this one or you can also pick this one. It's up to you. Let's say I do the first one, right? So it's 3 times the 1 plus the 4y gives you the 11. Okay? So I got 3 plus the 4y equals to the 11. Then it's 4y equals to, put a 3 over here, you get yourself an 8. Then y equals to 2. So your final answer, if they require you to actually write down the coordinate, it will just be 1 and 2. That's it. Thanks for watching.